Hello everyone, in this video we have one square and one semicircle, and then O is the center of the semicircle, and here is given 1, and this length is S. Okay. First of all, I want to represent one side of the square as Y. So here is also Y, right? Because of square. Next step, if we connect these two corners, notice that here this angle must be equal 45 degrees, right? Because of diagonal. And then if there's a y unit opposite 45 degrees, opposite of the 90 degrees here must be equal y root 2. If you notice that, this red line is also a radius of this semicircle, right? Okay. Therefore, here, this length is y root 2 as well. Okay. Let me clear here. After that, if we connect these two corners, this angle, notice that here is opposite of the diameter, right? Therefore, this angle is 90 degrees. Okay. And then let's call here alpha and here theta. We know that alpha plus theta equal 90 degrees, right? So here, this angle must be equal theta. If you focus on this triangle and this triangle are similar, right? Because they have same angles. So let's call here A, B, C, and D. That means triangle OBC and triangle ADC are similar, right? Okay. So y root 2, which is opposite of the theta, over x plus 1, which is opposite of the theta, must be equal x, which is opposite of the 90 degrees, over this length diameter, which is opposite of the 90 degrees. And we know that here is also y root 2, right? So diameter is 2y root 2. 2y root 2. Okay. So, after the cross multiplication, y root 2 times 2y root 2 equal x times x plus 1, right? So, for y squared equal x squared plus x, okay? After that, if you focus on this triangle, this triangle is a right triangle, so we can apply Pythagorean theorem, right? So, at the beginning of the question, we call here as y, right? So, y squared plus y root 2 whole squared equal x squared. Therefore, y squared plus 2y squared equal x squared, 3y squared equal x squared. Okay, that's right here. 3y squared equal x squared. So now, notice that if we multiply the first equation by 3 and the second equation by 4, these two equations become equal to each other, right? So 12y squared equal 3x squared plus 3x. And second equation, 12y squared equal 4x squared. Notice that these two equations are equal, right? So if we equalize these two equations, 3x squared plus 3x equal 4x squared, 3x equal x squared, so first root must be equal 0, right? And these are again, and then the second root must be equal 3. That means x is going to be 3 units. Thanks for watching, and if you want more videos like this, please don't forget to like and subscribe. Take care and bye-bye.